A breadboard is a device most commonly used when prototyping rather simple circuits. Its good reusability of components makes it a very cost-effective tool for prototyping. Now let's have a look at the basic structure of a breadboard. Usually, we can differ between two areas on a single breadboard. One area is for the voltage supply. This is this area here and the area down here. The other area is for the circuit itself. This is where all the components should be placed. The holes on the breadboard are usually 2.54 millimeters apart. This is the same distance the legs of the through-hole components are apart. In order to connect components, the holes have to be somehow electrically connected. Here we have to differ between the two areas. In the supply area, the holes are connected horizontally, so along the length of the breadboard. In the component area, the holes are connected vertically, but just until the middle, where the gap is. This gap separates the upper and the lower side of the component area. This makes the use of ICs with this breadboard possible. So if we place an IC, the legs on the upper and the lower side are not electrically connected. Otherwise, one could not use an IC with a breadboard. Last but not least, some useful tips when working with a breadboard. First, try not to bend the legs of the components too much. If you do, they will eventually break off. Secondly, use enough wires. This greatly improves the transparency of your circuit and allows easier debugging. The last tip is to group your components in functional blocks. This is again helpful when debugging your circuit. My name is Lukas. I'm with the Institute of Electronics. I hope you have learned something today, but anyways, thanks for watching.